Thank you
very much.
Yeah.
All right. I know that quite a few of you already know Wikidata, but from the talks we've had last night, for example, there are quite a few who still don't know it. So I will give a bit of a short introduction to catch you up. So everyone needs access to knowledge. How many of you read Wikipedia? Yes. You're in very good company with about 500 million people every month. That's a huge number of people coming to Wikipedia in search for knowledge and information. But there is a problem. We have nearly 300 language editions of Wikipedia and other Wikimedia projects. But for example, only 79 of them have an article about the Zika virus. That's really important information that's not available to a huge number of people. Or if you look at it in another way, these are articles on English Wikipedia with a geo-coordinate. So for example, Frankfurt gets a dot on this map, the Eiffel Tower gets a dot on this map, and so on. You can see pretty much the outline of the whole world. But if you look at the same map for Spanish Wikipedia, it already looks different. Russian Wikipedia, Farsi, or Japanese. For some reason, the Japanese are really fond of Italy. But cool, right? Anyway, what this shows you is that a huge number of people don't have access to important information in their language. And 4.5 years ago, we said, okay, we're gonna change this. And Wikidata is one of the many ways in which we're changing this. Wikidata is a knowledge base. It's a central place where we store data about the world. Like Berlin is the capital of Germany, Barack Obama is the president of the United States, and so on. But actually, more importantly, Wikidata is a community of people curating that knowledge and information. This information is then provided to the Wikipedias, to the other Wikimedia projects, but also anyone outside of Wikimedia who wants to make use of general purpose data about the world. This is what it actually looks like. This is the item, we call it, about Mona Lisa, the painting. It has a name in different languages, a description in different languages, links to Wikipedia and the other Wikimedia projects, and a bunch of statements like that it is a painting and was created by Leonardo da Vinci. So where are we now? Right now we have about 24 million items, 2,700 properties, and together we use them to make about 120 million statements about all kinds of things in the world. This is all created by roughly 16,000 editors per month, which makes us the third most active Wikimedia project after English Wikipedia and Wikimedia Commons. And our Sparkle endpoint currently receives about 1.5 million Sparkle queries per day. What makes Wikidata special, and also how does it differ from SMW, for example? First of all, a community. There are 16,000 people who maintain this data and provide it to the world. We're not trying to determine the truth in Wikidata, but instead record what sources say. And I think this was one of the fundamental differences to SMW, for example. If you look at this, for example, when was Jesus Christ born? Or what is Jesus Christ, actually? We're not trying to be the place where people have to fight this out. That would just not work. Instead, we're providing references for all these claims. So, for example, on the item about Barack Obama, you have a statement saying that Michelle Obama is his wife since the 3rd of October 1992. And there's two references to where the statement comes from. One is there. One is a New York Times article, and the other one is an entry on Barack Obama's blog. The other really important thing, and that is kind of what Yaron was talking about yesterday in the hints to us, we're not trying to restrict the world. Over the past 4.5 years, while we've been developing Wikidata, it has become clear and clear again that the world is really weird and complex, and that we need to build a system that can cope with that. For example, as Yaron yesterday already showed, there is someone who's married to the Eiffel Tower. Or there is a February 13th, because Sweden in 1 year decided to have one. Yes, the Swedish people. And the other really fundamental difference to SMW, I think, is that we're providing this data in many languages. So, for example, the statement we had earlier about Michelle Obama being Barack Obama's wife, here you have it in English. But you can easily switch the page to also show it to you in German or in French. All of this together makes for a multilingual and multicultural project that acknowledges knowledge diversity and can also actually deal with it, which is super important for a project that tries to be a central place to share between the different Wikimedia projects, between the different cultures that represent those projects, and so on. What have we learned so far? A lot. But I will only touch the most important points. The world is really complex and complicated. And Wikipedians are really, really good at telling you where exactly and how exactly. World champions. There is no single truth, and you have to deal with that. The world is screwed up. You can't put it into little boxes, and you have to deal with that if you're building a product like Wikidata that is supposed to serve so many different audiences. But the good thing is, we've shown that it's possible to do that. We live in a world where, when you look at the popular map provider, depending on where you come from, they will show you different orders of countries without telling you that they're doing that. And that is just one example where this is happening, where today on the internet you're not exposed to a lot of important disagreements in the world. And I think that's not serving us well in the long term. And I think we should build a lot more tools that expose people to different points of view and so on. Data must be used and maintained. When people think about Wikidata, or I think any knowledge base, the first thing they think of is, oh my god, this is an amazing place to just dump all my data and build beautiful things. And in part that's true, but especially for a community-created project like Wikidata, it's really important that you also have the people to take care of that data, and that you don't just have a place to dump that data. Because data needs to be maintained. The world changes every day. And it takes a lot of time to do that, and a lot of effort to do that. And you need good tools to support the people doing that data maintenance. But if you build flexible and open tools and allow people to tinker with them and allow them to help themselves, they will amaze you and build really cool things. For example, this is the article about the South Pole Telescope on English Wikipedia. And the info box here has been switched to make use of Wikidata. Before that, the template definition and all the parameters for this info box was huge. Now it is one line. Or here, this is Histopedia. It's a startup that provides a service to build timelines of all kinds of things. Among the ways you can build a timeline is to make a query to Wikidata. Or here, this is Mix and Match. It's a tool to match up Wikidata entries with entries in other catalogs, like Project Gutenberg, and many others. Or here, that's a site called The Sum of All Paintings. And it is a website where you can see which paintings are in a museum that you're going to, or where paintings of your favorite painter are exhibited, and so on. All based on data from Wikidata. Or here, that is the Wikidata game. And it basically asks you very simple questions. Like, here's a Wikipedia article, is it about the person or not? Stuff like that, and depending on your answer, it will make edits for you on Wikidata. Or here, that's Inventaire. It's a website where you can indicate that you have a book and are willing to give it away to your friends or strangers. So basically to encourage book sharing. And what they did in order to save them a lot of time and brain was to use Wikidata to build these author pages. So a lot of the data that you see on this page, like description, the image, date of birth, date of death, where this person comes from, and so on, is all coming from Wikidata. So they don't have to maintain all that data and still give their users a really nice experience. Or here, let's ask Platypus. And it is a site where you can ask a natural language questions, like who's the director of the movie Her? And it will answer you based on data in Wikidata, that it's Spike Jonze. What's coming up next? The thing we're working on right now is the article placeholder in order to address the problem that small Wikipedias do not have a lot of content. So they're in this kind of vicious cycle where you have a small Wikipedia that doesn't have a lot of content. Because they don't have a lot of content, they don't attract a lot of readers. Because they don't attract a lot of readers, they don't have a lot of editors. And because they don't have a lot of editors, they don't have a lot of content. And that's really a vicious cycle for them. What we're trying to do with the article placeholder is to provide some content to these Wikipedias when you search on one of them. And there's no article on a project, but Wikidata has data. We will offer a kind of data sheet to to the reader and encourage them, based on that data, to write an article for that project, hopefully getting them out of this vicious cycle. The next thing we're working on is automated list generation. There are a lot of list articles on Wikipedia, like the list of airports in Germany, stuff like that. And it is really hard to maintain those, especially for the smaller Wikipedias. When a new head of government, for example, is elected on English Wikipedia, on German Wikipedia, and a handful of others, people are really quick to update them. But especially on the small Wikipedias, they just don't have the manpower to do that. So we will provide them with tools to generate these lists automatically based on data that is in Wikidata and have them updated as data is updated in Wikidata. We want to have better connection to the link to Open Data Web because right now we're kind of a dead end. We want to support multimedia data on Wikimedia Commons. Right now, when you're looking for an image on Wikimedia Commons, it's really hard to find what you're looking for. because the ways to find high quality images that fit your criteria are just not good enough. And one of the reasons for that is that the metadata about a file, like under which license is it, what does it show, who took it, are all in templates in Wikitext stored with the file. Those are not machine readable. It's really hard to build search and query tools on top of that, for example. So what we're going to do is move that data to structured data, and then hopefully make commons live up to its real potential by exposing much more of the great images and videos and so on that's in there. And the final big thing we're working on is support for lexicographical data, like it is on Wiktionary right now. Same problem. There's a lot of really great stuff on Wiktionary, but it's not in a machine-readable format. It's really hard for people to reuse it. It's really hard for people to contribute. And hopefully with the data, with the support from Wikidata, we can help them be much more useful to their users and so on. Thank you very much. Questions?
Yeah, I've been thinking about my question the entire talk, and I wonder if I'm naive or if the world is just very complicated and not very simple. The idea that there are 220 languages, but a fact is a fact regardless of the language is central to a lot of work. I was wondering where the mechanism for consistency sits in the architecture or the framework that you have. And to what degree do you make one fact be universal to all the languages, or do you accept with Wikipedian wisdom that the world is complicated and perhaps different languages just simply have different truths?
Mm-hmm.
I very naively, I would think, when the case I read online, someone dies, we need to write down in 220 different places what the death date was for
right.
The person. Do you see that you actually write that down in one place and then it gets filtered through all the languages?
Right. So in this case, for example, a famous person dies, like Shimon Peres a few days ago. Then the idea is that it is entered in Wikidata with references, and then any Wikipedia can make use of that data. Currently, info boxes on Wikipedia are changed to make use of Wikidata data. It's a gradual process. The editors decide per info box template or even per article what kind of data they wanna have. Some Wikipedias, for example, switch an info box template to make use of Wikidata, but in individual articles you can still overwrite it. Some completely ignore Wikidata, others are using it just to compare their own data against Wikidata's data, and some just use it completely. So it depends, and it's a process that's currently ongoing and will probably take us a few more years.
There's a mechanism on Wikipedia where an author can voluntarily set up a call to Wikidata.
Yes.
And that can be also set on the template level across
yes.
all languages.
Right.
Do you have cross-language templates?
No.
Okay, so you actually have to put, it's less bad, but you have to put 220 places for 220 templates per language look up the date of death.
So, for example, if you have a template for an info box about people, if you change that template once and it's used on English Wikipedia on a million articles, then all of those articles that make use of that template are changed as well.
But there are 220 different info boxes for people.
That's the thing, there are not. Unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, because especially the small Wikipedias don't have the people to code all these info boxes. With global templates hopefully coming at some point, we can support them even better.
My last question, what's the percentage of coverage, more or less, and how do you expect that to grow? Or how much of the data on Wikipedia has such a call to Wikidata?
It's basically impossible to tell at this point. So I really don't know. It's not enough. Yeah. More questions?
In the beginning of your talk, you mentioned one of the differences between Wikidata and Semantic Media Wiki is that, if I put that right, Wikidata is about statements or references, whereas Semantic Media Wiki is kind of saying what the word is like and determining the truth. And I didn't quite get that point. I would like to ask you to explain mm-hmm. that a little bit more, because of my understanding is, say, I could create the statement Jesus Christ is a God in Semantic Media Wiki by creating an object, be it a page or subject, some object like Jesus Christ, and then a relation is, and then an object page God. So then I have that statement which could be coded on a page. Mm-hmm. And again, that page could be referred to by another page, like the page Pope, with a relation believes that is true, and then comes that page, whereas the page Ayatollah Khomeini does not believe, and so on. So I would think Semantic Media Wiki, depending on how it's used, would just allow the same thing. And I've always understood or assumed that Wikidata is simply another method in handling huge amount of data, which I think Semantic Media Wiki would run into performance issues, you're using that amount of data that you just showed. But could you explain the first categorical difference that you referred at the beginning of your talk?
Okay. So yes, you can probably do something similar with Semantic Media Wiki, but it hasn't been built with this idea in mind from the start and as a core belief of the system as it was built. While Wikidata was really from the start built with this idea that we are a secondary database, we're not the ones who have the truth. We're the ones who say, okay, they say that, they say that, they say that. Does that make it a bit clearer? Okay.
Hi, yeah. I don't know if you mentioned it, but the software Wikidata uses is called Wikibase.
Yes.
And it's available as sort of software. Every once in a while on the SMW mailing list, there's someone who asks, you know, I'm thinking of, should I use Wikibase for my project? Mm-hmm. And usually maybe a few weeks later they come back and say, well, I tried it and it's too complicated.
Yeah.
So, do you have any thoughts about that? Are there cases where people have used Wikibase successfully, or are there cases where they could design mm-hmm. Wikidata?
So there are a few cases where people use Wikibase outside Wikidata, and I definitely want to encourage more of that, because I don't want Wikidata to be the place where people think all of the data needs to go. I want it to be the place that's central in an ecosystem. So it has general purpose data and tells you where you can go for more. Just like Wikipedia, if you have an article about a topic, it doesn't have to cover the whole topic. It has to give you a good introduction, maybe even quite deep. But then it sends you to other sources where you can find out even more if you're really interested and if you need to know. And I see Wikidata kind of similar. And an important piece of that is, of course, having more projects use Wikibase or something similar to be able to interact with the data there. One project that, for example, uses Wikibase is the Eagle Project. They have images of, I believe it was gravestones with inscriptions, and they are describing these gravestones using Wikibase. There was Another one that is starting now, they are using Wikibase to store information about shops, basically. So they want to get people away from buying in huge chain stores. So they're making maps of small family shops and so on to give people an overview of the alternatives they have. And they're using Wikibase for that, hopefully. In contrast to SMW, I think it really depends on what people want to do, what's better for them. Yeah.
Is it possible to have entities on Wikidata that are not on Wikipedia?
Yes. There are notability guidelines on Wikidata, just as there are on Wikipedia, but they are less strict, for starters, because they need to encompass all the Wikimedia projects. So it's not as strict as any single one of them. Nonetheless, there are notability guidelines. If you just search for Wikidata notability guidelines, you'll find them. It has 3 points, rather easy. But they're, in terms of the amount of data, we just have to have some point where we say, okay, that is what we cover, that is not what we cover, and that line is going to shift as the project grows. But we need to give the editors the tools to deal with more data before we pump in more data. Yeah.
So it's more a technical restriction for now?
It's not so much a technical restriction, it's a social restriction, I would say. In terms of how much the people we have can deal with and want to deal with and are capable of maintaining in the long run. Because Wikidata wouldn't be useful for anyone if we just pump in huge amounts of data that no one is maintaining.
The truth. That was an interesting question, Carson. It struck me also that SMJ established the absolute truth. When I teach courses about the semantic web, there's a beautiful word that I use called assertion.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think the difference is that, I don't think either party says there are absolute truths, but an important difference is that this Wikipedia and also Wikidata are more document-based. The assertions there have citations. On a semantic processing level, it is difficult for logic processing to have citations, because what you then have are assertions about assertions, and that's called reification. It's supported technically on semantic web, but people who build systems don't like to do it, and many logicians are fundamentally opposed to it. So that's the it's not an absolute truth, but it's unsupported assertions. You can say that someone is a god and a person on semantic Wikipedia. You can also say it on the semantic web, unless you set up a rule that says gods and people are always different people, and then you get an inconsistency. But that's also not saying something is true or not true, it's just saying there's some assertions here that don't go together, but you can still have a system that handles them all.
Yeah.
And I think that's the important difference. That's also nice about the openness, because of the fact that you aren't establishing absolute truth. Systems like semantic naming wiki can be open and let assertions be used in processing the system.
That's true. References for Wikimedia are, of course, really important, because people can come and change the content, and our references are one way of keeping things in check and giving people the power to actually check if what is written in Wikipedia, for example, is true.
But it doesn't matter if it's true. In terms of processing, it may be
in terms of processing, it might not matter. In terms of what people expect from Wikipedia and the rest of the world, I think it matters a bit.
But then people have the ability to make up their mind about
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.